بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه. Last time the reminder was about this infradi ibadat or salat service. Is it bala or ibtila? For some, it is bala. Bala, it is punishment, it's strong reminder. For ibtila, it is ikhtibar, imtihan, test, difficult. Yes, but to get them to be more patient and more determined. For the first group, punishment, to remind them, you've been given the opportunity for Salatul Jama'ah, for Salat, prayers in Jama'at. Now you don't have the opportunity, so they can regret it. How many times I pass by the masjid, how many times I've been called to go and pray in Jama'at, in congregation. Yes, and each step you can tell, it is hasana, it's a merit. Each step is removing one of my bad deeds. Each step is elevating me, is taking me up one degree. So all this being taken away, and now is Salat al-Infradiyya in many cities here and there. For example, in some European cities, countries. For the ibtila, for the ikhtibar, the reminder was, that's for us, for those who are very keen, very determined, not to miss one Salat al-Jama'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us to keep up going to the masajid for Salat, even if it is infradiyya, if it's individual prayer service, we still to go. Sometimes I advise myself, you used to go to the masjid 5 times a day. Try now, if it is possible, for individual prayer service, go 10 times. What to do? I'll go, I have my own prayer mat. I'll stay myself. What to do? Raise your hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remove this calamity, this test, this pandemic situation. And let us subhanahu wa ta'ala to have again our masajid as used to be, with Salatul Jama'ah, with no social distance. By mentioning about social distance or distancing, we already, in the last reminder, were reminded that we Muslims have been, had this for long time. Could be years, could be centuries, Allah knows best. In one masjid, how many times we, as individuals, felt that I'm not belonging to these people, not belonging to that one, because he's from the north of the village, he's from the south, he's from here and there, or he's from that movement or this movement. We are different thoughts. But do we have, after all this sense of ijtima'iyya that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalalu is remind me and you in every Surah Al-Fatiha with the Noon Al-Jam'ah, what is called in Nahu, in Arabic, Noon Al-Jam'ah, the Noon of plural. It's not the Alif of Fard, the Fardiyya, the singular. It's not A'budu, it is Na'budu, Iyaka Na'budu, wa Iyaka Nasta'in. This should go deep in our hearts, that I am one, yes, I'm responsible, I will be accountable for my a'mal, but it's not only myself, it's we. Iyaka na'budu. You alone, that's how we should say it, to the effect, you alone, we worship, we, yes? We the Muslims, we the people who are in Salat. What about Nasta'in? You alone we seek help. A big lesson. Ijtima'iyya. Again, for bala, the punishment, a strong reminder, and ibtila, a test. So we face it with patience, inshallah. Ijtima'iyya. This belonging, this social life, where did it start? Did it start here in this dunya? They teach people in sociology, in social sciences, and we learn this, we told this, that al-insanu hayawanun ijtima'i. Insan is a hayawan, is a social animal. We Muslim corrected, we say al-insan makhluqun ijtima'i. Insan, human, is a social, created being, a social being, cannot stand alone, cannot stay alone, cannot, have to be together. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed an-nas, ya ayyuha an-nas wa inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. Oh, people, who have created you from a male and female. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ. And we made you different people, different nations, and different tribes. لِتَعَارَفُوا. So you acknowledge, you recognize, you help each other. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The one who is really honored, who's closer to Allah, the one who got taqwa. When he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was asked about who are most beloved to Allah, أحب الناس إلى الله, that Allah loves them most, he صلى الله عليه وسلم answered with one كلمة, أنفعهم, the most beneficial to them. If you are means of benefit to people, if you are from the ummah that Allah سبحانه وتعالى جل جلاله mentioned in سورة آل عمران آية 104 to the effect, let an ummah, let a group of you to call to khair, to goodness, and to enjoin good, and to forbid evil. وَأُولَيْكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And surely they are the truly successful people. وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ. Ayah 104. Ayah 110, look at that. From just a group, from us, from the ummah, to takleef, to giving this responsibility to every member in the ummah, everyone. Kuntum, you the Muslim, you the people of Iman, kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. You people, the best, being sent to the welfare, to the goodness of people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rabbul Nas. And our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah said to him, wa ma arsalaka illa kaffatan linnas. كَفَّةً لِلنَّاسِ. For every nas, for everyone, do I consider everyone human. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for him, for her. Think about it. And if you are with this worry, with this concern, you are most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than many, because you are anfa'ahum. And anfa'ahum, the most beneficial, who are the Anbiya alayhi salatu wassalam, and the Imam of the Anbiya, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Nabi, because it's the real beneficial to all of them. A question to me and you. If you've been given, I've been given an opportunity to serve someone, to help someone from our respected dear parents and grandparents and our relatives and our friends and our neighbors, do you feel that you do ihsan to them, you benefit them, or you understand they also have done ihsan to you? Have they done ihsan to you? They've given you an opportunity. They let you to have it. Listen, if there is no people, they are there in need, how are you going to do it? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the means for you to be muhsin, to be good, to benefit them. So from the depth of your heart, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then thank these people for giving you opportunity for khidmat, for service. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalalu, let us understand, let us take this time of individual prayer service to think about collective prayer service, that we are all one ummah. Put in our mind, I cannot be just myself, me, I and myself, but I have to be considerate. I have to be means of khair, of good, means of salam and rahmah, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not just was sent to Muslim and mu'min, but he was sent rahmah lil alameen for all. And take his amal sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as yours, take his work as yours, and say, I'm here for the khair of people. خير أمة أخرجت للناس جزاكم الله خيرا تقبل الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.